Behold, it is laid over with gold and silver, and there is no breath at all in the midst of it. Every man is brutish by his knowledge. Every founder is confounded by the graven image. For his molten image is falsehood, and there is no breath in them. They are vanity, the work of errors. In the time of their visitation, they shall perish.
Ye shall make you no idols nor graven image, neither rear you up a standing image, neither shall ye set up any image of stone in your land to bow down unto it. For I am the Lord your God.
Behold, they are all vanity. Their works are nothing. Their molten images are wind and confusion.
I only wanted to show I'm trying to restore this city. I'm trying to restore the corruption. I'm going to try to improve this statue.
I am the Lord. That is my name. And my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images.
In those days came John the Baptist, preaching in the wilderness of Judea, and saying, Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. For this is he that was spoken of by the prophet Esaias, saying, The voice of one crying in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight. And the same John had his raiment of camel's hair, and a leathern girdle about his loins, and his meat was locusts and wild honey. This is what Jesus said about John the Baptist in Matthew 11:11. Verily I say unto you, among them that are born of women, there hath not risen a greater than John the Baptist. John the Baptist certainly was an excellent servant of God, but knowing John the Baptist will not save anyone, knowing John the Baptist will not get anyone into heaven, the name of John the Baptist will not save anyone. It is specifically the name of our Lord, Jesus Christ, that can save us. Acts 2:38 says, Repent, and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. We are all sinners, myself included, but when we repent, we turn away from our sins, and we look to our Lord Jesus Christ for help, to help us stop sinning, to help to lead us away from temptations. We look to Jesus Christ to help us overcome evil.
Is there a God beside me? Yea, there is no God. I know not any. They that make a graven image are all of them vanity, and their delectable things shall not profit. And they are their own witnesses. They see not nor know, that they may be ashamed.
So at a Catholic church, there's a sign over here I want to take a look at. What does it say? Doggone premises.
Yea, they are greedy dogs which can never have enough. And they are shepherds that cannot understand. They all look to their own way, every one for his gain from his quarter.
Beware of dogs. Beware of evil workers. Beware of the concision. Men disobey God when they bow down and worship any idol or image. To avoid God's wrath, bow yourself down to no image of any kind. The Bible tells us of a strange future when the world will worship the image of a beast. But they that worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. Be faithful to the Lord Jesus Christ, the kind, merciful, and loving God, our Heavenly Father, and obey His commandments, and be saved by His power. Fear no man, and do not place your trust in any man, but put your trust in the true living God and wait on Him to be saved by the Lord Jesus Christ.